I'm looking over there because I have my notes and I don't want to keep like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to keep looking at it. What is up, you guys? I am super excited for today's video because today we're going to be talking all about cameras. Well, actually, no, not just about cameras, but we're going to be talking about photography and how you guys can make your photography, your photos, whatever, how you guys can make your photos a whole lot better. I'm super excited for this just because I'm a photographer myself, but these were just three things that were really drilled into my head when I started out photography in my freshman year of high school. That's when I started photography. You got your composition, you got your lighting, and you got your background. Tip number one is your composition. Now, your composition is everything that is within the frame. Right now, what you're looking at me and you're looking at everything else that's in this frame. So I made sure that I centered myself so that you guys can focus on me and not like the picture over there or like my door in my room. When you're looking at your composition, you want to make sure that the subject in the frame is interesting and that the way it's placed in the frame is very unique. Because if it's just centered in the middle of the frame like I am right now, like, it's just gonna be boring. People that look at photos, they don't wanna look at just like a regular photo that's just like, oh, here's a butterfly in the center of the frame. How pretty! And it's like, yeah, that's nice, but you wanna put it up in the corner and have some flowers underneath it or something like that. So you wanna make sure that it's interesting, it's unique, and it's something that you want to look at for more than just like 2 seconds. A tool that you can use to help you get really interesting compositions is the rule of thirds. If you open your phone to the camera on your phone, or if you just go on your camera, if you open the grid on your phone, so like, that's what it would look like. I don't know if you can kind of see it, you can't really see, but if you open the grid lines on your phone or on your camera, it'll show you like this grid where it's split down here, and then it's split across the frame like that. This is what you can use to place your subject other than the center of the frame. So if you want to, you can put your subject in each of the corners that the grid lines connect. In the general sense of photography, you always want to use those grid lines to help you create those really unique compositions. Now, when you're talking about portrait photography, which has been my personal favorite lately, for portrait photography, it's different for me because I think of it as, okay, this is the subject, it's a human being, this is the most interesting subject, so I want people to look at this, so I'm gonna put this in the center of the frame. And that's usually how I think about it. If the subject is interesting enough, then that's the only time that you can really put it in the center of the frame. But if it's just like, I don't know, like an Xbox controller or something like that, then maybe you can like tilt your frame or something, or you can tilt your camera at an interesting angle and have the focus be in the corner. If you got one of these things, like maybe you had it like, you had it tilted like this, you had your camera here and everything was out of focus, and the one thing that was in focus was this red button here. Now you want to put this red button in the corner of the frame, one of those four corners, so that way it kind of leads the viewer's eye into that corner. So when we're talking about putting something on the, not the center of the frame, but on like one of those four corners, or even like the sides of the frame, that can be a helpful contributor to creating a really interesting composition. If we look at this photo of my friend that I took, she's an amazing photographer. I highly recommend that you guys go check her out. I'll put her link down in the description below to all of her social medias. If we look at this photo, she is standing on the side of these flowers, right? And so I made sure that I positioned the camera to have her be standing on one side of the frame and the flowers take up the rest of the frame. And that she's not just in the center of the frame, just standing there. The flowers add an extra interestingness to the composition. And they complement her jeans. Like, yellow and blue, those are complementary colors, okay? Do you even go to art school? Because I do. This picture was the perfect example. Next is gonna be your lighting. So for me, lighting is really difficult because if you're working with professional lighting kits, it can be really tricky because you wanna make sure that you have all the sides exposed perfectly and you don't want any shadows. And it's just, it can be a pain in the butt sometimes. When we're talking about lighting, you wanna make sure that your subject is not too overexposed or too underexposed. Otherwise, it can be kind of difficult to look at. You don't really want to look at a photo that's like blown out, completely white on one half of the frame, your subject's on the other half, you can't even see it. It's just a mess. So you want to make sure that your subject is nicely exposed and if it's a person that you're shooting, you want to make sure that they that their face is nicely exposed. If you want, you can play with shadows. So this picture right here, this is a friend of mine who lives near me, and she's an artist, and I will also put her links down in the description below. She makes some really cool stuff. I highly recommend you guys go check her out. We were in the city. I asked her to go stand up against the wall, and I got this picture of her. And if you look at the lighting here, yes, her face is exposed a lot, but you can also see some shadows near the eye and in her eyeball. And by her hair, you can see the shadow of her hair. So if you really want to, you can play around with how shadows work on people's faces, or just like in general. You can really use lighting to your advantage, and you can use shadows to your advantage too. Lastly is your background. Now, you'd wanna make sure that everything in your background is not distracting and not taking away from the subject. Because if you have, like, say you're shooting like a flower or something, and then in the background, there's like a dog like peeing on the grass, you're not gonna really want that, because then the viewer is gonna be like, oh, what is that dog doing? Or that's a really cute dog, I wanna look at that instead of this like flower. But yeah, you wanna make sure you have a nice plain background, or even maybe like a textured background if you're getting like a top-down shot of like an object or something like that, just to make sure that your background's not taking away from your subject, because the subject is what you want the viewer to be looking at. So you can use a lot of different things to manipulate the viewer's eye. When I was in high school and I was taking photography, my teacher had always told me, like, make sure your background is plain, or not plain, but she would always tell me, like, look out for your background, because you got a lot going on back there and it's distracting. And like, I remember I was showing her this one picture of a friend that I took, and she was just like, this is great, but your background is whack and half of her body's cut out. And I looked at it and I was like, oh wait, yeah, you're right. So always make sure that your background is not too distracting. And if you have a camera, and if you can create some nice bokeh, which is a blurred effect, then that's even better, because if there is anything distracting in the background, it won't really show too much. But you still want to make sure that there's nothing like sticking out or looks like it's cutting your head off, or like just really bizarre and distracts from your subject. Another thing with background too is if you have a horizon line, so say like you're at the beach or something like that, and you have this model or whatever. That is such a like typical example, like you have a model at the beach. Say you're taking photos of a dog or like a person or whatever, and you have the nice beach horizon line in the background. Well, if it's crooked and really off kilter, then it's gonna look a little strange. And going back to the rule of thirds, if you turn on that grid, you can use that grid to your advantage, and it can help you to get that straight background that you're looking for. And even if like your background is like really crooked, you can always just fix that in post-production. So you don't have to worry about it too much, but it's best that you can get your picture as nicely exposed, as perfectly straight as you can. That way you don't have too much to fix afterwards. That is all for me today, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you learned a little bit of something. I just really wanted to share this with you guys just because I love photography. And I'm like working at it a lot, and I've been taking a lot of photos lately. So I thought it would just be something interesting to share with you guys. And if you have any like anything to add, or anything that you think I or the rest of us should know, then write it in the comments. So if you guys like this video, you should probably go check out my other videos. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace! Okay, I want to be like really close, so I'm like awkwardly trying to, okay. Alright, let's do this. Hey you guys! Ew! My parents are actually gonna think I'm like crazy or whatever. This is not okay. Oh my god, my freaking, what is hair? Today, I'm really, really excited to, I don't know what I'm saying anymore. What is English? The TV stopped playing. I think my parents can hear me. They probably think I'm crazy. Alright, what is up, you guys? No, this... I don't know. Can I look at this? Can I, like, use this to... I don't want, like... You don't want to hear paper crinkling, right? Like, no. Maybe if I put it... Maybe if I, like, put it here. Then I can just, like, glance at it. Three things that you can do. That the grid lines connect.